Escort one to Overlord, scanning for hostiles now.
Not today, scum. Escort one to Overlord. Spring the trap.
We have you now.
Target locked.
One is mine. Blast! So close.
No matter. Their story will warn others against challenging us. Let's regroup.
Commander.
Malgus.
Your assistance with the 38th Fleet's operations has been exemplary, but I am now recalling them for a special assignment. Emperor Vauron wishes you to join a meeting of the Dark Council aboard Vikan Space Dock. We will discuss the details of the operation there. Few outside of the Sith have ever been invited to such a meeting. Such is our respect for your strength.
I'm glad I could help prove the value that non-Sith bring to the Empire.
You and those like you may yet teach the Empire the full strength that it possesses. We await your arrival. Malgus out.
The Meridian Complex. A state-of-the-art Republic shipyard. It nears completion on the planet Corellia. My spies report that it can produce ships faster than any of our shipyards and at half the energy cost.
That hardly seems possible.
Based on the technical readouts Zarian has acquired, I assure you it is entirely possible. Perhaps it is even a conservative estimate.
A dire threat indeed. But the solution is obvious enough. Malgus, Krovos. How will we destroy the Republic's shiny new toy,
By securing our frontline positions and withdrawing all but the most crucial warships, we have formed an assault armada of unrivaled size and power.
Under our command, this mighty fleet will burn the Republic's new shipyard to ash and destroy any hope of victory that might remain among their people.
Committing so many ships is dangerous. What if the Republic has their own fleet ready and waiting for you?
You will ensure that they do not.
We have gathered enough fuel ships to carry our fleet to Corellia without stopping. Our enemies are in no such position. The Republic will scramble reinforcements from all corners of the galaxy. Wherever they stop to resupply, we must disable or destroy them.
We have already identified one likely refueling point for the Republic ships. The planet Onderon.
Conveniently, I am already engaged in operations to undermine Republic control of that planet. However, my forces are meager, to say the least. But with the aid of the Alliance and its commander, I am confident that I can successfully delay any Republic reinforcements that pass by.
Your predecessor wasn't the most focused ally. I hope you do better.
I'm confident that we'll work well together.
Splendid. The die is cast. Zarian, continue gathering intelligence on the shipyard and its defenses. Anathel, Shah, I trust you will share all necessary resources in a cordial and supportive manner.
Of course.
Perfect. We are adjourned.
Commander, fancy meeting you here.
Major Anri, are you joining the mission on Onderon?
Nah, I pulled Darf Shah's operation this time. We're headed for some mined-out rock called Mekshar, but word is we might catch up groundside on Corellia.
I've missed you since Oxus. How have you been?
Same old. Fly here, blow up that, sneak into this, kill everyone. You know the drill. To tell the truth, once you've fought with the best, everything else just seems a bit dull. Know what I mean?
Major Anri, I need to speak with the Commander. Alone.
Of course, my lord. Please excuse me. Until next time, Commander.
It is the nature of Sith to seek their own advancement. Members of the Dark Council, most of all. Victory on Corellia benefits us all. It advances us all. Should Lord Savik or any other council member forget their priorities in my absence, the Emperor grants you leave to remind them.
I don't expect to have any problems keeping them in line.
Good. Lord Savik awaits you. Farewell, Commander.
Come in, Lana. Our objective is Onderon. Take everyone we can spare. You'll be briefed on arrival.
Understood. We'll depart for Onderon at once.
Welcome to Onderon. This is the Royal Hunting Lodge of King Petrith, the current ruler of the planet.
Onderon has been a Republic planet for centuries. Not that Petrith cares, he just wants to sell his planet's resources to anyone willing to pay.
Which is where the Empire comes in.
Exactly. Petrith's greed makes him an easy target for Savik to manipulate, but his nobles aren't playing along.
Petrith may have the throne, but the nobles have control of the capital city and day-to-day operations. If they learn of his Imperial ties, he could be deposed.
What about the Republic fleet we're here to destroy?
Still gathering in orbit. They're preparing for refueling and resupply operations.
Savik doesn't have the resources to attack the fleet head-on, so we're pretty sure she's gonna trick Petrith into doing it for her.
Forget Savik. Call in our ships and order them to destroy the fleet. Simple.
Commodore Pardax strongly advises against it. The Republic fleet is sizable. We would incur significant losses and couldn't guarantee total destruction of the enemy.
Ready to get started?
I was surprised to find you absent upon my return from the Senate, my king. Do you expect to visit the capital soon?
I will return when it suits me.
We have matters to discuss. When do you think it would suit you to return?
You overstep, Senator. It is your job to share my decisions with the Republic, not to question them. Do not bother me again! The nobles' meddling was bad enough without Nebet to stir them up further. This is intolerable. Am I not king? Do I not rule this world?
They clearly don't respect your power, dear king. And to send this senator back here. Perhaps the Republic believes you need more supervision. But you need not concern yourself. I have brought a powerful ally to ensure nothing comes of your enemy's plans. Allow me to introduce the Alliance Commander.
It's already clear that you stand apart from the greatest and wisest rulers in the galaxy. A truly special king.
Ah, yes. Well, you're wise to see it so quickly. Welcome to my world. Nebet's provocations have utterly drained me. A hearty meal will aid my recovery. Do enjoy your visit.
As you can see, the king all but eats from my hand. He is the key to our victory here. Onderon's capital is equipped with powerful defensive cannons that could easily destroy the Republic fleet in orbit. The cannons cannot be operated remotely, but if we spur the king into a civil war against his nobles, the distraction will suffice. We will infiltrate the capital amid the chaos of battle, seize control of the guns, and eradicate the Republic fleet before they even realize they're in danger.
Why the distraction? If he's king, can't he simply walk us in? Or just order his people to fire the guns?
Most of the palace staff, especially the soldiers guarding it, are loyal to the Republic. We can't risk them warning the fleet before the cannons are fired. Petrov already suspects that his nobles are moving against him. We need to push that paranoia further. Through intermediaries, I have hired a band of mercenaries to infiltrate the hunting lodge and assassinate the king. Fortunately, you will swoop in to defeat these deadly attackers just in time. You will save the king, earn his trust, and push him further from his nobles all at once.
Can you tell me anything specific about these mercenaries?
They're an interesting mix. Gand finds men with droids in support. An odd group, but they have a reputation for skill. If my calculations are accurate, the mercenaries will arrive any moment now. I'll be happy to guide you to them over the comm. Good luck.
Don't ask questions. Take your wounded and leave while you still can.
I take it the ruthless assassins have been dealt with. Now that the area has been secured, we can exit the safe room.
This is an outrage! They think they can kill me? Me! I am the king of Onderon!
Once they realized your strength, Nibet and her Republic conspirators knew they could no longer hope to control you. Killing you was their only option.
But I'm the king!
Yes. I have deployed my droids to defend the premises. I assure you that you're now quite safe.
Good, good, excellent. Well done, yes.
My king, what of your cousins? They're still at the ancient proving grounds.
And? What do they have to do with any of this?
It's possible they're in danger too, good king. If your enemies are attacking you, they could also target your family. But the commander who valiantly saved your life can certainly rescue your cousins as well.
Your enemies are clearly ruthless. It may already be too late, but I'll do what I can.
Inconceivable! They have royal blood! I can't believe this! My blaster! I need my blaster! Oh, where did I put it?
His gullibility exceeds even my greatest estimates. We have given him fear. Now, we must give him anger. Find the king's cousins at the ancient proving ground. Kill them. Then spread evidence that Nibet is to blame. Petrov will demand retribution, and we'll have our diversion.
I seem to be doing all the work, Savik. When will you contribute to this mission?
My talents are best devoted to controlling the king and preparing my droids for the eventual assault. The Onderon wilds are treacherous. You should take a guide with knowledge of the terrain. Speed is crucial. The Republic fleet is about to begin refueling, but my plan is unfolding perfectly. Victory will be ours.
Ah, Commander. I believe I've found a pair of local guides we can trust.
Chikaru? C2D4?
Better than they treated us, clearly. We really need this.
What have you been doing since Yavin?
Working for a succession of idiots and cheapskates.
I shall leave you in their capable hands, Commander. Good luck.
Hands.
Not one step closer. Identify yourself.
I don't talk to corpses.
What? I don't understand.
I'm tired of all this nonsense. Let's go back to the capital.
Get down! For Onderon!
How dare you!
Our cousin is the king!
I know, but I can't kill him yet, so your deaths will have to tide me over.
You'll regret this!
Savik, Petrov's cousins are dead.
Such a tragedy. I'll inform the king they were slain hours ago. Well done. Savik, out.
Commander, good. The king is attempting to rally support for an invasion of the capital. Your efforts were beyond successful. My plan unfolds precisely as scheduled. The king will rejoin us momentarily, having realized he lacks the military support to reclaim his palace. He will ramble about traitors, demand the blood of his enemies, and remind us yet again that he is king. Then, with the simplest prodding, he will realize where to acquire the troops he needs.
What do you have in mind? Imperial reinforcements? More support from the Alliance?
Neither, actually. Observe.
Traitorous! Cowardly! I want them all dead! Nabet, the nobles, my worthless bannermen, the Republic, all of them!
Dear King, surely your allies rallied to your cause.
Some did, and they will receive a king's reward, but far too few. We cannot take the capital with such a small force.
I only wish the Empire could provide more aid in these dark times. No one else on this world has the strength to challenge the nobles and their off-world comrades. It seems impossible to believe.
No. Onderon's strength is not yet lost. There is one group. They've hated the nobles for years. Tried to undermine all relations with off-worlders. I always dismissed them as backward and paranoid, but perhaps they were right all along. About the Republic, that is. They are known as the Untamed. Their leader is a Beast Lord, a Kuru. He's a keeper of Onderon's old ways. But he will not join us easily.
Please, King Petrov. If we cannot supply the troops you so badly need, at least allow us to win this ally for you.
Akuru and his Untamed are proud and stubborn. They have no more love for me than the nobles. I'm not sure how you could secure their allegiance.
These Untamed can join our fight or die. I'm sure they'll make the right choice.
You are a fearsome ally indeed. Your reward shall be great once my throne is reclaimed. I will prepare myself for war. Good fortune to you, friends.
All too easy. The Untamed are Onderon's only other major group. Once they're weakened by joining this attack, they will pose no further threat to Imperial operations.
There is a proper way to seek an audience with them. An old ritual. They love old rituals.
Excellent. And one more thing. I've learned that Akoru's elder brother, Rutan, once trained as a Sith. He died fighting Republic forces on Hoth. The rest of the Untamed aren't aware of Brutan's service. To leave Onderon and serve off-worlders would be abhorrent to them. Perhaps a useful bit of leverage over Akuru.
How did that happen exactly?
Brutan's master served Darth Jadus. I expect they hope to train him, then send him back to seize leadership of the Untamed and disrupt Onderon's Republic-friendly regime. Unfortunately, that plan never came to fruition. It would have made our task much simpler. I must finish preparing my own droids for the assault. It is best if any Imperial identifying components are removed. Good luck.
Desecrate our shrines, flaunt our traditions, and then have the gall to come here? I am a Kuru, Beast Lord of Onderon, and I do not tolerate insults. Speak quickly if you want to live.
King Petrov is attacking the capital. Your warriors will help him.
Oh, you are a bold one. I'm intrigued. You think insulting our ways will convince me to help a man I hate? The Untamed are the true masters of this world. We know everything that happens here, including Petrif's idiotic squabbles with his nobles. Why help one against the other when I want you all dead?
This is your chance to prove you're stronger than Petrif and his enemies put together.
Perhaps so. But do not enter another's home and tell them to prove their strength without proving yours. You consider yourself above our traditions. But now that you are here, you can no longer dismiss them. You will face my mightiest war beast in ritual combat. Then we will see what you are truly made of. Cross your luck. Feeding time!
Ha ha! I'm honestly a bit impressed. No, not that. The name, Crashalock. It's actually a pretty clever pun, if you speak ancient Onderonian. Crashalock. Classic.
By the Pax of Duxen, you have a strength that cannot be denied. I will rally my best fighters. Your foolish king will have his war.
I kill one mindless beast and you're willing to march to war?
I'm happy to use an inevitable battle to our advantage. Based on what I've seen, your side will triumph. Untamed! Hear me! The hour of our vengeance has come! Gather your weapons! Harness your beasts! Today, we show the galaxy the true strength of Onderon!
I'm telling you, an idiot doesn't come up with a pun like that. Or speak a forgotten language. Insane? Perhaps. Xenophobic? Bigoted? Murderous? All fair. But he's not an idiot. Not the bigger idiot, anyway.
Debating relative idiocy, are we?
They can't decide who's dumber, Petrif or Okoru.
Really now?
Onderon, your conquering king returns! After this day, none will question my power!
Excuse me?
He said you are sure to win, O mighty king.
I am indeed. Our noble forces await us. To war!
Between Petrif and Okoru, the capital's security forces should be adequately distracted. While they attack the main gate, my droids will blow open the city wall near a sewer bypass. That will be your entry to the Orbital Defense Cannon's control center. Once you destroy the Republic fleet in orbit, our victory on Corellia will be one step closer.
Where will you be during the assault?
Remotely directing my droid commandos. They will supervise Petrif and Okoru to ensure they stay on task. After all, I wouldn't want to waste all this effort we've put into undermining Onderon's government. To that end, once the fleet is dealt with, you should regroup with Petrif and his troops. If you aid them in defeating Senator Nibet and her Republic allies, Petrif can rule unchallenged as the Empire's puppet. Onderon would be ours.
We're here for the Republic fleet. That's it. Taking over the planet isn't our job.
Do as you will, but I will not turn away from a prize that is all but in our grasp. I will deploy my droids to clear a path. Good luck, Commander. This will be a day long remembered.
Thank you.
Savik, come in. The cannons are disabled. Petrif or Okoru must have damaged the power grid in their attack.
Blasted fools. We'll think of something else once the palace is secure. Please, hurry to the throne room.
All of my droids have been destroyed. I have no visibility. But if you ensure Petrif's victory, I'm sure we can find another way to disable the Republic fleet.
Please. This is our last chance. Savik out.
Onderon will return to the old ways. The pure ways. Your blood will wash away centuries of desecration.
You don't fight for Onderon. You fight for your own bigoted agenda. You fight, and you lose.
His loss is my gain, Nabet. I've beaten you. I've won!
Did you really believe you could steal the throne of the great King Petrif?
Steal your throne? What in blazes are you talking about?
No sense lying now. Your treason is over. I've won.
Who's there? Show yourself!
The Republic fleet escaped.
Oh, they have escaped for now. With the Commander's aid, I am certain we can still stop them.
The Republic fleet escaped.
This is only a setback. We have countless alternatives to pursue.
The Republic fleet escaped.
Savik failed, but her death won't solve anything.
You will depart for Corellia at once. We will find a use for you yet, Savik.
Yes, my lord. Commander, thank you.
We have no more time to waste. Onderon has been an abject failure. Another fleet of Republic reinforcements is docking at Mekshar, as Darth Shah suspected. That will be your next target. Rendezvous with Shah's forces, and ensure they succeed where Savik failed. Malgus out.
So, what's our next stop?
Set course for Mekshar.
Ah! We know it well! A mined-out asteroid converted into a fueling station. We would love to join you. If you think your alliance has room, of course. Please?
Please?
It's been a pleasure working with you again. Welcome to the Alliance.
Wonderful.
I have a shuttle prepped and ready, shall we?
Commander, welcome to Mekshar, outlaw crossroads of the galaxy. Darth Shah, I'm pleased we finally have an opportunity to work together. I've heard such delicious things about you. I oversee Imperial logistics and civil order. My expertise with the galaxy's criminal element led to my taking direct command of this operation. This intriguing specimen is a member of the Brothers, our key allies on the station. They've provided the Empire with quality slave labor for many years.
It is our great honor to take those without value and give them value, to give labor to those without purpose.
Why don't you tell me your plans for Mekshar?
As direct as your reputation. Our goal here is more complex than it might seem. Let's step into the operations center to discuss the details. Wait. There's some... What? Oh!
Blazes was that?
I have no idea, but I appreciate the help.
Anytime. It's good to see you again. Lord Shah still in one piece?
Oh, yes. The Force was strong with him. Pity he didn't stand a chance. For a Sith to defy Emperor Vauron and attack you in the middle of a priority mission. You must have done something truly stirring.
He was no match for me, and he knew it. Let's get back to the mission. If he tries again, I'll just kill him.
I'm going to enjoy working with you so much.
Shall we?
Now then, let's review the mission parameters. A Republic fleet, key to the defense of Corellia, has taken position nearby and intends to purchase fuel from Mekshar in order to continue their journey. It is our task to ensure that this fleet never reaches its destination.
So we stop them from refueling.
I'm afraid that won't be enough to suit Emperor Vauron. If the fleet cannot acquire fuel, they'll simply consolidate what fuel they have into their most powerful warships and send them on. We do not have sufficient vessels to prevent this. And we must make every effort to stop the entire fleet.
Then we lure them in and attack while they transfer the fuel.
Precisely. Major Anri, explain your discovery.
It just so happens that a perfect weapon is built into this rock. All we have to do is take control of it. See, this place used to belong to the Hutts, till their slaves revolted and kicked them out. Now Mekshar's neutral, run by the five biggest crews on the station. Hutbreaker, she led the revolt. Well, she wanted to be sure nobody could show up and steal what she and the other slaves just won. So they put in a failsafe. It fires a pulse that neutralizes all the fuel in Mekshar's tanks, plus whatever's in the fuel lines, and any ships attached. We could even juice the pulse up a bit. Make it strong enough to ignite the fuel everywhere but the tanks. Fry every ship in the fleet.
Perfect. How do we get started?
The decision of whether to sell fuel to the Republic fleet hasn't been made yet. It depends on a majority vote by the top five crews. It falls to you to persuade them to vote in favor of selling the fuel. To help the Republic walk into our trap. As it happens, you have a perfect chance to do just that. Brother?
Hutbreaker hosts a celebration, an auction of pointless material wealth gained without effort. The five strongest crews are invited.
You join our dear friends at Hutbreaker's auction. Ensure that the crews vote in favor of selling the fuel, and help the Republic slip its head into the noose.
Consider it done, Lord Shar.
I will remain in contact should any other urgent matters arise.
And watch your back. At least one of these crews is already in the Republic's corner, or the fleet wouldn't have come here in the first place.
Good luck, darling.
Fancy meeting you here, boss.
We were catching up with Theron and Lana, and they mentioned you were here. Figured we'd lend a hand.
We've cut a few deals with these people over the years. With our help, you'll know just how to play them. They'll vote however you want.
If you already know these people, why don't you handle the negotiations?
All of the deals we've cut were small time compared to this. Convincing them to fuel up Republic warships will take some clout.
Dealing with someone big and important like you feeds people's egos, makes them easier to win over. You're definitely the one for this job.
If you're ready, let's head inside. All right, first up, Hutbreaker, revolutionary leader, liberator, and unofficial queen of Mekhsha. Her crew runs the main docks.
She won't need much convincing. Selling that fuel will bring in a small fortune, but that only stands if you keep the peace. You get too messy with any of these gangs, Hutbreaker will lock things down no matter how much she stands to make. Keeping Mekhsha safe is her top priority.
All right. Darth Shar said that one of the crew leaders is a Republic sympathizer. What can you tell me?
Junker Jot, retired Republic Navy. His people handle maintenance for all of Mekhsha. They're the reason we've got air to breathe and a nice view that doesn't kill us.
Jot doesn't really have a crew, just droids and other engineers like him. But without them, this place literally doesn't work. So they get a seat at the table. Needless to say, the Republic will get his vote to refuel, so no need to get involved there. Better to focus on the other crew leaders.
Why bother with the others? Hutbreaker and Jot will vote in the Republic's favor. We tell the brothers to do the same, and we have a majority.
The brothers' relationship with the Empire is no secret. If they suddenly vote to sell fuel to the Republic, it will seem way too suspicious.
Yeah, it's more of a hassle, but you'll need a vote from one of the other crew leaders to keep the Republic from looking too closely.
First is Veet the Snake. He runs a Rodian smuggling ring, the Harito Wald. One of the biggest operations in the galaxy.
Veek's a businessman. He can be anybody's friend if there's an upshot for him. Just have to figure out what he needs and make sure he gets it. The other crew leader is Indigo, Mandalorian. Well, ex-Mandalorian. Same with his crew. They're called something like
Darmanda. They're mercs and gunrunners. Indigo has some kind of rivalry with Veek, so it's a good thing you only need one of them to vote your way.
Veek or Indigo? Simple enough. Thank you for your help.
What are friends for?
Looks like Hutbreaker's about to give her big welcome speech. Let's find a good spot.
Mekhsha! How are you doing tonight? Look at us! We are surviving! We are thriving! We are turning this tiny rock into the beating heart of the galaxy! Just a few years ago, we were slaves. Now, we're masters. Imagine what we can become in just a few more years! All we've got to do is stay us. Be what we've been so far. We keep the peace. We keep the balance. And we keep moving forward! We've got the whole galaxy laid out in front of us. Everyone else just doesn't see it yet. All they see are the soldiers, politicians, Sith, Jedi. All the people who think they run things, who think their wars decide who's in charge. The truth is, they'll never be in charge. They'll never really run things. You know why? Because while they're busy killing each other, we're making deals, making friends, expanding everything they buy so they can blow each other up. We're selling and getting richer, stronger. By the time they stop and do the math, it will be too late. Because there will be a lot more of us than there are of them. And then, it will be us calling the shots. So stay the course, my friends. It only gets better from here. Welcome to Mekhsha. Did you enjoy this speech?
I can see how you were able to inspire the rebellion against the Hutts. I think you're one good blockade away from realizing who's actually in charge.
Well, the Hutts did most of the work for me, if I'm honest. Someone just had to fire the first shot. Now then, please, enjoy our hospitality. Have a drink on me and keep the peace. You can keep the peace, yes? I have your Sith friend's word on it.
The Sith aren't known for keeping their word or keeping the peace.
Such cynicism! Commander, meet Tawidir, Jedi Knight.
Leave while you can, Jedi. I won't tell you again.
I don't answer to you.
The two of us have a prior appointment, I'm afraid. Please, enjoy the auction.
I know you helped Malgus on Ossus. You picked the wrong side. And you're going to regret it.
You have nothing to fear from me, Jedi.
We'll see.
Master Jedi.
See you around.
Keep on walking. I got nothing to say to imp lovers.
Chonki faguta de obora geotokakise. De monte que caça do bonilis de oto. Chai concunta chichai.
It's always better to do business with friends.
Wahota spii ok o ina basta. Conchita chichakta. Chukusa mala chikuta. Ikosa mose ala tuta. Kobane puta taise jeskusku.
So what do you think about those Republic ships out there?
Kasuyali koyaran kenka kurum. Kliskataka yos osko ukopokuta. Makipuna male tuta o mishka. Mitisa roda kopana cha porko utmangisa.
It'd be better to discuss this in private.
Bampaula kavaji oto.
You know what I want, but what is it that you want?
Chubula wa michade sula. Kastu undile jio hola lukuta. Tungi machechu kuti nankihe. Wana wa de bloto wichawa.
Get friendly with someone else. I got nothing to say to you.
How about hello? That would be a good start.
You're wasting your breath. I don't deal with your kind.
Then I'll stop wasting it. I don't need the Darmanda.
Fine by me.
So that went well.
You could have warned me.
And have you miss out on that fun little chat? Kidding! 100% honest, we didn't know he hated Mandalorian so much. Now that I think about it, I bet he's just trying to keep up his ex-Mando tough guy act in front of everyone here. Word is he spends a lot of time brooding in the cantina. If you were to run into him there, he might be a little less surly. Maybe. Worth a shot.
Ah, there you are. Have you learned everything you need to complete our plan?
Yes, I'm done here.
Splendid. I hope your time was illuminating.
How'd I do? Too scruffy? Just scruffy enough?
Scruffy isn't the word I'd choose.
I couldn't agree more.
Gonna do a hit and run on Jot's turf a bit later. Need to keep the old crank from realizing who's behind it. Just need a few more sets of gear for the rest of my boys and we'll be off.
I've rather loudly let the actual Nova Blades, as well as the Exchange, hear that I'm hiring extra muscle. Word should spread quickly.
I'm on my way to meet with one of the crews we need to vote for the refueling.
Wonderful. I knew you were the one for the job. Well then, we all have our tasks before us. Shall we reconvene in the Brothers' territory later?
Why did you come here?
I don't like the way you're talking to me.
It's about to be more than talking. You understand me?
Stop the threats. It would be smarter to work with me.
You think I'm gonna work with someone like you? You better spit it out fast. What do you want?
I want you to vote in favor of selling fuel to the Republic.
You want them to refuel? I don't know what your game is, but I don't need to. You know how this works. You do a little something for me first, and I'll consider it.
How can I be sure you'll hold up your end? Vote first, then we'll discuss payment.
Or, maybe we don't make a deal at all. You're the one who came to me, remember? Here's my situation. You know that slimy little Ronian Vink? Runs a smuggling crew? He's been raising prices on me, and I'm sick of it. Profits are thin enough without that bug-eyed scammer butting in. I want him and his bodyguards dead. No witnesses. No chance the Darmander catches the blame. I know the guy is next in line. Done business together. He'll hire some of my guys as bodyguards and I'll be in a nice spot. So, there it is. Take out Vig, and the vote's yours.
You can count on me. Vig is as good as dead.
Take this communicator and get somewhere out of the way. Buzz Vig with it, and he'll think Hutbreaker's calling for him. Use it to call me when the job's done. Once I see it with my own eyes, we'll be golden.
Mitisa Roda, Kopana Chaporko Utmangisa? Wonkiki Ato Chan Kampat Noka, Chisa Picha!
Job's done. Good. The boat's yours. Good luck with your war.
If you decide you're interested in mercenary work for the Empire...
If I get that stupid, you'll be the first one I call. See you when I see you.
Commander, am I interrupting anything?
I just finished convincing Indigo to support our plan. What do you need?
Perfect. Remember when I mentioned that hit and run on Jot's territory earlier? Well, I've got my squad ready to move. Last thing we need is you.
What do you mean?
Jot's crew handles maintenance for everything in the station, including the failsafe system that roasts the fuel. He'll have a schematic for the failsafe on his computers. We need that data so we can modify the system to juice it up like the boss wants. My team hits Jot's place first, so he thinks pirates are trying to run off with some of his repair droids. While he's out chasing us around, you sneak into his HQ and grab the data. Sound good?
Send me the coordinates and I'll make my way there.
You got it. Before we dive into this op, I have to tell you, I feel like Shah's playing games here. Treating those creep slavers like they actually matter. Hell, playing nice with any of the locals. Boss's eyes are on more than just the mission, I'm sure of it.
Members of the Dark Council always look out for themselves at least as much as they look out for the Empire.
Shah, especially. All right, I've earned enough of your time. I'll move my people into position and we'll be ready to start when you are. Amri out.
Major Amri, I'm downloading the failsafe schematics now.
Copy that. Think we finally have the old fool locked down. Gonna snag some droids and make our getaway before he gets loose again. Henry out.
Thanks to your impressive efforts, the vote has gone as we intended. Mekshar will sell fuel to the Republic. Their ships are preparing to dock now. It's clear that they have no idea what we intend. Once their ships are locked into fueling position, we will begin our assault.
I've gone over the failsafe schematics with my boys. We'll break into the maintenance shafts and hit the four main emitters all at once. Someone else will have to throw the big switch, though. Can't activate the failsafe from inside. Has to be done from the dock's control center.
Leave that to me.
We're of the same mind. Excellent. Before you begin, I will load the remainder of our troops into assault shuttles and make a diversionary strike on the docks themselves. That should serve to distract the bulk of their defenders. Still, do be careful as you approach the failsafe controls, darling.
I don't want to see you hurt either.
Wouldn't want to spoil the victory party, after all. Oh, to see their ships gutted by the very fuel that they were so desperate to acquire. This will be a glorious day for the Empire. I only hope our upcoming victory on Corellia shall be similarly poetic. Our trap is set, and our prey circling within it. Let's show our Republic friends the futility of their best-laid plans.
I've reached the failsafe controls.
Got two of the four emitters. Best we're gonna do with this much resistance. Good enough! Activate the failsafe, now!
I'm trying. There's something wrong. The console just exploded. The whole system must have failed. The console shows that all fuel has been neutralized, but there isn't enough power to ignite it.
No! No! This can't be! Abort! Abort the mission! Everyone retreat!
You made an all-out military assault on my docks! Meksha isn't Imperial territory. You don't get to ignore my rules!
Your concerns are noted. Meksha's neutrality ends today. You will officially ally yourself with the Sith Empire. We will establish a modest garrison here to ensure the ongoing prosperity and security of our new friends. In exchange, you will provide us with a valuable fueling station for our operations in this sector. Or we will find new management. I'm sure we won't need to resort to such drastic alternatives. Will we?
No.
Splendid. You're excused.
Shah, report.
The Republic fleet has escaped.
That is disappointing, Commander. How did this happen?
Just a lot of bad luck. It was nobody's fault. There was nothing anyone could have done.
I find that difficult to believe. The combined strength of the Republic's Onderon and Meksha fleets will present a significant challenge to our Corellia operation. I'm transmitting coordinates now. We will meet to discuss our strategy for the attack immediately. Malgus out.
I appreciate your support, Commander, more than you can know. I do hope our next mission together can end on a more pleasant note.
My lord? Orders just came through. Looks like I'm backing you up on Corellia. Heard they have good whiskey. Might try and grab some.
Don't bother. Kalsenor's blends are just as good, and much simpler to find in Imperial space.
Maybe so, but you know what they say about a looted bottle.
The truest taste of victory.
Oh, I like this one.
I've enjoyed working with her so far. Major Anri, this is Lana Beniko.
Charmed.
Hey, I saw the Sith leave. Am I clear to come in now?
One of yours?
Most of the time.
Are we good to go or what? This is not the best neighborhood.
Lead the way.
Commander, everyone else is with the fleet en route. Save the Emperor, of course. He's back on Dromund Kaas. I'll connect us.
Commander, thank you for joining us. Darth Shah sent her compliments for your assistance on Meksha. It's a great pleasure to know that the two of you worked so well together.
If only your operations had resulted in fewer Republic reinforcements, our work on Corellia would be more straightforward.
Walk me through your plan for the battle.
Given that the enemy is unaware of the details of our strategy, their fleets will assume a flexible defensive formation in geosynchronous orbit above the Meridian Complex shipyard. Contrary to their expectations, I will take most of our ships to the far side of Corellia, forcing at least some of their vessels to break formation and engage us.
What makes you so certain that they will follow you?
Indiscriminate bombardment of the planet's surface. Cities, industrial centers, resource caches. We will be impossible to ignore.
Taking a huge fleet to serve purely as a diversion? You expect us to believe that's your only objective?
My only objective is victory for our empire.
With their formation broken, our technological advantages will allow us to punch through the remaining defenders and conduct a surface assault on the complex. The last of our dreadnoughts, equipped with Isotope 5 reactors, will escort the ground assault force through the enemy's blockade. Meanwhile, the silencers commanded by Moff Pyron will destroy any Republic capital ships that attempt to interfere.
Tell me more about these silencers.
Harrower dreadnoughts, modified to carry state-of-the-art mega-laser main cannons. They can destroy enemy capital ships in a single shot.
Once we reach the planet's surface, we will attack the Meridian complex from multiple directions, seize its control center, and disable the shields protecting it from orbital bombardment.
From there, our ships reduce the complex to slag, and the Republic's best hope for victory crumbles into dust.
Splendid. I do enjoy the intricacies of your strategies. But what of our honored guest? How do you plan to include the Alliance?
The silencers are vulnerable to starfighter attack. With the Alliance fleet to escort them, that risk is all but nullified.
As for the commander, I would welcome such a deadly ally in my surface attack group.
Let's hope you can keep up with me better than last time.
Rendezvous with these coordinates. Our attack begins as soon as you arrive, Commander.
I shall look forward to reports of our great victory. Good hunting.
My boys have a ship fueled and ready for us. They're practically drooling. Most of them have never seen a battle this big. They'll be competing for the most kills. Care to join the pool? Winner takes any interesting gear or other goodies we managed to plunder on the way out.
I'd rather win some time alone with you.
My time's not something you win. Besides, once we've hit the surface and dropped everyone who gets in our way, it'll just be the two of us, right? Shall we?
Commander, proceed to these coordinates to join our assault formation.
All ships are in position and report ready.
Let the battle begin.
Proceeding with bombardment, targeting all major population centers.
Silencer group, move to your designated firing points. Surface attack group, advance.
Isotope 5 generators at maximum output. Engines at 322%, shields at 563%.
Energy levels like that, flying this close together? Our little ships will never even show up on their scopes. We're all but invisible.
You're concentrating fire! Trying to pick us off one by one!
Ignore them. Maintain course and speed.
Shields! Failing! For the Empire!
Holding course! Holding!
We have breached the Republic's defensive line.
All ships, break formation. Scatter!
They can't shoot at us now. If they miss, they'll hit their own people on the surface.
How many lives did we lose to make that happen? How many ships?
Merely a fraction of those the Republic will lose when we've finished here. Surface attack group, proceed to your landing coordinates. The final phase of the battle is about to begin.
hands up!
Don't shoot! I'm a pacifist.
Who are you?
I'm Theron Sedrax, obviously. Preeminent expert in exotechnology and senior design engineer for this facility.
Theron, huh? Bet you have a buddy named Theron.
Another Theron? He probably spells it the stupid way. Presumably, you're here to seize control of the facility? Or perhaps to sabotage the defensive systems?
Make yourself useful or you're dead.
I would love to make a grand speech about never giving up and choosing death over dishonor, but the truth is, the situation is out of my hands. All defensive systems, shields, anti-aircraft guns, and so on, have been transferred to the secondary control station near the top of the spire. All of this equipment is useless now. So there's really nothing to be accomplished here, and nothing I can help you with.
Commander.
Apparently the shield controls have been transferred to another control center, higher up in the spire.
Is that so?
None of the computers will respond, my lord. And I'm seeing some lightsaber burns over here.
That was the Jedi, Tau Adair. She's commanding the last of the facility's guards. She severed the connection as soon as control was transferred, then headed upstairs.
Then we have our target. Commander, on Ossus, we united our strength to crush the Jedi who tried to oppose the Empire. It's time we repeated that triumph. Join me. And together we will win a victory for the Empire that will change the course of the galaxy forever.
I've met this Jedi before, on Mekshah. I'm going to enjoy taking her down.
Good. Major, hold this position, no matter the cost.
Yes, my lord. And what about him?
The scientist who built this facility could be very useful. We should keep him alive.
Whatever you say.
I should have stayed on Nar Shaddaa.
We'll keep you covered. Good luck up there.
Hold it! Oh no.
Steady. Fear is a deadly weapon, but only if you let them have it.
I was hoping we'd run into each other again, Jedi.
We've got your back, Tau.
Fools. Not one of you could hope to defeat us.
You're not fighting one of us. You're fighting all of us.
Then you will all die. You are beaten. Your shipyard will be obliterated. Your Republic will crumble. And your fellow Jedi will be hunted to extinction. Your destruction is inevitable.
As inevitable as gravity!
Catastrophic structural damage detected. Shield power at maximum. Evacuation protocols recommended.
Anri, the Jedi smashed the controls. There's no way to bring down the shields.
I copy. Raven to command. Shield controls disabled. No alternate controls available. Please advise.
All units, evacuate. The mission has failed. The shields cannot be disabled in time. Regroup at RV Point Crash.
You heard her, people. Move out. Fall back, everyone. Fall back!
Commander, that was just about the finest work I've ever seen. I know you're in the thick of it, but stop by the cantina later. Same place as last time.
Have you lost your mind? Why would you call me here?
Well, showing up in person seemed a bit risky. See you soon.
The strategy was clearly flawed. There can be no other explanation.
The strategy was perfect. The fleet held up on its end.
You suggest that Darth Malgus and the Alliance Commander, perhaps the two deadliest beings in the galaxy, are the ones who fell short?
No, I merely suggest that our strategy was not at fault.
Ah, here is our beloved ally now. I'm sure there is a perfectly understandable explanation for these events.
Malgus isn't the man he was. He slowed me down, and gave the enemy the time they needed to ruin our plan.
Where is Malgus now?
Never you fear, he lives on. Though his recovery may take some time.
Much like our once beautiful armada. Rather the worse for wear, no?
The silencers remain intact, thanks to the cover provided by the Alliance fleet. But our Isotope V reserves are all but depleted, and we lost many more ships than we'd anticipated. All of this might have been a worthy trade in case of victory, but in defeat, we will be forced to cede significant territories.
Then we must turn to our beloved allies to find the strength we require. My dear Commander, we must depend on your alliance now more than ever before.
What is your plan moving forward?
Let's continue this conversation alone, Commander. The rest of you may go. This outcome makes one thing quite clear. The Empire requires an organization more suited to direct, decisive action, free of the interference of the Dark Council. A group answerable only to me. Our past emperor had such a group, the Hand. But its members were a pack of fanatics and madmen. So I will form my own Hand. Its members will be the Empire's most powerful and loyal warriors. From now on, your alliance will coordinate operations alongside the Hand only. The Dark Council will hold no sway over your affairs. Fighting together, the Alliance and the Hand will be too powerful for any enemy to withstand. Our Empire will be unstoppable.
Do you plan to have Malgus serve in the Hand?
I do. He will act as your liaison as well, once he's able. I'll have to find someone else to fill in. For the time being, rest and prepare your people for the battles ahead of us. After all, victory favors the prepared. Farewell.
I don't care. The body count is too high.
This is war. Deaths are inevitable.
I don't believe that. We could have stopped Krovos. We should have.
Theron.
I know you didn't pull the trigger on all of those civilians, but you didn't do anything to stop it. What's the point of taking them apart from inside if you're not saving any lives along the way?
A spy really should be more flexible. I confess, being fully funded by the Empire might have made our daily operations easier. But I have no qualms with our current arrangement. I'm told there's quite a raucous party up in the officer's lounge. Would you care to be the star guest? Yes, that's a much better idea.
Hey, thanks again for finding me that bottle.
Of course. If you need anyone to share it...
Count on it. Mind if I borrow her a minute?
I'll find you later.
Pretty crazy stuff, huh? Ossus wasn't even that long ago.
We've already made it through so much. That's war, I suppose. Still, most grunts aren't lucky enough to work with the deadliest fighter in the entire galaxy. Which reminds me, too bad you didn't join the bet. You'd have won for sure.
How about that time alone we were talking about?
Gonna have to wait, I'm afraid. I actually came to talk about something else. Back on Corellia, I didn't actually make it out with the rest of the shuttles. Got caught under some falling debris and all the chaos. I wouldn't have made it out at all if they hadn't lent me a hand.
Who?
An old ally you never met.
You're the one who tried to kill me on Mech Shah.
Don't take it personally.
It was a test. Nothing more.
A test you actually passed.
What are you talking about?
I am Lord Scourge, once a loyal servant of the Empire.
Kira Carson, Jedi Knight. Not thrilled to be here.
All three of us have fought the same enemy. The former Sith Emperor, Tenebrae, Vitiate, Valkorion, whatever you wish to call him. We know he was once a part of you. And we both felt his destruction, but he has always been a master of deceit. We had to be sure that he wasn't lingering in your mind, hidden, waiting to come out only in the most dire circumstances. Now, we are sure.
You try to kill me, and now you expect me to trust you? Just like that?
I know it's hard to believe, but we're all on the same side.
We can't risk saying more here. Let's travel to your base on Odessen. It should be safe for us to talk there.
About what?
The final, gruesome weapon of Tenebrae.
What a mess.
I have removed all compromised components. Where shall we begin repairs?
Checking the failsafe is always fast. Emperor Vauron had us double the explosive charges after the Osis mission. It was a real pain to hook up.
Yes. I examined the device after removing it. Highly complex.
You removed it? What are you thinking?
It was rendered inoperable due to damage. Replacement is required. Interestingly, it was the only damage not caused by crushing impacts. The exterior perimeter was actually cut by a high heat implement.
Oh no.
Give me the droid. And a ship.
The hero of the hour. You've made me a very popular man back at the office. Your tab is my tab now, friend. Seriously, you don't know how much this win means for us. Saving the shipyard without breaking your cover? Absolutely incredible work.
We have the Empire backed into a corner. They won't last long now.
Let's hope you're right. I want to put you in touch with a friend of mine. One of the best covert operators I've ever known. Commander, this is Master Saldaren.
A pleasure.
Salinar friends have some big plans coming up, and I think you could be a big help.
Few Jedi survived the war with Zakuul. Most are scattered to the far corners of the galaxy, hidden, awaiting a sign of hope to return to the fold. We intend to give them that sign. Very soon. And when we do, the Empire will try to stop us at any cost. You can stop them in ways no one else can. Warn us of impending attacks. Feed us intel on lost comrades. You can help us save the Jedi.
We're here. Now tell me what this is all about.
As I told you on Vikan Space Dock, Tenebrae's last gruesome weapon. He sought immortality, but only his endless spite survives now. I was his most powerful servant once. His wrath, but I learned of his true nature and plotted his downfall for centuries. Ultimately, I saw what had to be done and betrayed my empire in order to destroy its creator. That is how I came to fight alongside Kira.
We fought the Emperor's servants constantly for years. We even thought we'd beaten him alongside my master. Then Yavin 4 happened. And Valkorion.
I received guidance from an old ally. Instead of seeking out our enemy in his current shell, you, as it turns out, we sought a different target. Tenebrae hid his original body where no one could harm it. As long as that body remained in stasis, the galaxy's greatest evil could never truly be killed.
Unless we destroyed Tenebrae, the fight against Valkorion would never really be over.
Since Valkorion is gone, I assume you succeeded.
We did. As we later learned, we destroyed his first body just as you purged the last vestige of his twisted spirit from your mind. That is when his final weapon was unleashed. A Sith ritual, carved into his very flesh, unleashed an ancient plague from every molecule of his decaying corpse.
We were both knocked out cold, comatose for more than a year. Satil Shan was the one who finally pulled us out of that nightmare and started a new one.
Like you, Kira and I have both been vessels for a portion of Tenebrae's power. It acted as a sort of vaccine. But Satil had no such protection, nor did any of her followers. Within days, they were all laid low, trapped in a nightmarish slumber. In helping us, they unknowingly doomed themselves.
Sith rituals? A forced disease? I don't really see how I can help you with this.
You're the only one who can.
The infection is worsening. There is a darkness growing among the afflicted.
We can feel their minds connecting, communicating. We're afraid they might be merging somehow.
Merging into what? Another Valkorion? Is this plague bringing him back somehow?
It's too early to make that conclusion. Whatever it is immensely dangerous. We must stop it.
How?
We loaded Satil and all of her followers onto a transport to keep them quarantined, along with a few medroids to tend to them. The transport is programmed to fly a random course through unsettled sectors of the Outer Rim, all weeks away from civilization. I can send a signal to alter the course, bring it to another empty system that's closer so that we can meet it in a shuttle.
We board the ship and connect our minds with yours through the Force. Together, we will face this entity and purge it from existence. And if we cannot purge it, then we destroy the transport and hope we've ended the old monster's schemes forever.
This still doesn't sound like something I can help you with.
You shared your mind with the most powerful and malevolent entity the galaxy has ever known. And you managed to destroy it. Utterly.
If you can swing that, this ought to be a walk in the park. It's gonna take a while for the transport to come back into range.
Then we should stay here until it does. If you require any assistance in the meantime, don't hesitate to ask.
Not so fast. I'm not fighting the Republic or the Jedi, so if that's what you want, definitely hesitate to ask.
Ignore her. If necessary, I can slay enough of your enemies for both of us.
Ugh.
She grows on you. Eventually.